So this is the setup for G measurements. Now you see the photogate and photogate's cable, it's the platform, and this is LabQuest that will take the measurements, and this is picket fence. This will be freely fall through the photogate to determine the G, and we will have three runs for the G measurements. On the first one we will measure G 3 times, on the second run 5 times, on the third run we will measure G 10 times, and for each run we will take some medium of these runs and we will record the error values. So let's first plug the photogate cable to the digital end of the LabQuest, and as soon as we plug it, we will see this gate state. Now it's unblocked because there is nothing through the photogate. When I put my hand, it says blocked now, and when you cross the photogate you see the state is changing from blocked to unblocked or vice versa. The first thing we will do is we have to set the LabQuest sensor data collection, and this user defined value of the picket fence lines, the line distance should be 0.038 meters, and the data collection should end after 10 events. Each event means these lines passing through the photogate. So having set this data collection, and we press OK, and now we are ready to take the G measurement, the first G measurement. How we do it is we just hold the picket fence just above the photogate like this, and we will leave it freely through the photogate, but before that we have to push this button and then let it go, and you will see that LabQuest have taken the measurements of distance and velocity, and on the velocity you see the velocity of the picket fence is increasing, and this increase is uniform, so we will be able to determine from this uniform increase of velocity the G value, the gravitational constant or the acceleration. And to find this, what we do, we push the analyze button, and the analyze button we choose the curve fit and we choose velocity, and on this screen, since the type of the graph is a linear, we choose linear fit, and from the linear fit the computer can calculate the slope. As you see in here, the slope is calculated as 9.8106. this is the G value, and it's very close to the theoretical value actually. And on the bottom of the screen you see root mean square error. This is the error in the measurement of or drawing the straight line graph, and this is 0.002, etc. So what we do is we record this G value on our first run. What was it? It was 9.8 81, and after the decimal point, let's record this as 3 decimals, 810, plus minus, we record the root mean square value 0.002, 0.002. So this is our first run, or the first measurement in the first run. For the first run we will do 3 measurements, for the second run we will do 5 measurements, and for the last run we will make 10 measurements of G, and we will finish this part.